Issues, which some people may know the book of. It's a period drama set in the 1930s, and it's got a wonderful cast. Emma Watson from the Harry Potter movies is in there, but also Victoria Wood, who won a BAFTA for her straight acting on Housewife 49. She's in it again, playing a straight role. Absolutely wonderful. It's a beautiful story about young girls trying to find their destiny in life. It's lovely.
Well, it sounds fantastic. Thank you very much for helping us. Help yourself to a glass of champagne. It might be a little bit too early for you. We've got to go and find Carol Kirkwood. Where is she? She's somewhere around.
I'm over here, Chris. I'm over by the Christmas tree and, of course, the market stalls, and they're starting to open up now, but have I got a treat for you. Earlier this week, when we had them on the programme, we had an overwhelming response from you about how great they were. So we've brought them back. Our very own breakfast beatboxers, Bellatrix, Neil and MC Zenny, with their own take on a traditional Christmas carol. So take it away. Hey guys.
Silent, silent, holy, holy, all is calm, all is bright, sleep in heavenly peace.
Silent night. Holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round the Virgin Mother and Child, holy infant so tender and mild.
YouTube. And if you want to find out more about you, well, do check out our website. And Bill and Susanna, it's your turn now.
Well, yes, Carol, funny you should say that, because you've got a couple of beatboxes in the studio.
When this young lady saw that, she nearly took off, didn't you?
Yes,
you
were off.
Yes.
Who's ready to go?
Yeah. Okay, that's 10. That's a 10.
That's a 10.
Max?
Can you
just hit the cheek?
Yeah!
Oh, five. Strictly Come Beatbox. Fantastic. Yes. Morning, guys.
Morning.
We'll talk to you more in just a moment.
Just a moment.
About how you're all feeling. First, though, here's a last quick look at what's happening where you are. Oh,
good morning. Wigan Athletic Football Club will find out later today whether they've won their big battle in the High Court. They're trying to get nearly £300,000 back from Greater Manchester Police for what they describe as overcharging for policing on match days. But GMP maintain that the increase in charges was entirely fair. A High Court judge is due to make a ruling on the case later today. The MP of jailed Liverpool supporter Michael Shields is hoping yesterday's lie detector test will put pressure on the Bulgarian authorities to pardon the 21-year-old. Shields was returning from the European Cup final in 2005 when he was charged with the attempted murder of a Bulgarian barman. Louise Ellman says the result of the test is part of a mounting case showing his conviction is unsafe. The father of a missing teenager from Blackpool has made an emotional appeal for his daughter to come home for Christmas. Paige Chivers walked out of the family home after an argument in August this year. Her father, Frank, says that all he wants for Christmas is for his daughter to come home. Now let's take a look at the weather, and generally a rather grey day with some low cloud and mist, but some parts could see sunny spells. Temperatures only reaching about 4, and tonight murky, misty and temperatures dropping to -2. That's it for me. Gordon's here at 1:30 with the lunchtime news. For now, though, have a very good day. Bye-bye.
Welcome back.
For a moment.
We have this is the noisiest set of guests I've ever had. We're going to try and get through this before we start talking. Are you ready? Shh, just a second.
Order.
They have waltzed, wowed, and wept their way through 3 months of ballroom competition. Now, the singer Alicia Dixon and actor Matt DiAngelo will finally go head-to-head in a bid to win the Strictly Come Dancing crown.
They've taken precious time out from putting the finishing touches to their five dancers to be with us this morning. We're going to talk to them in just a moment. Good morning to you. First, let's have a look at how they got this far.
I can now reveal the only couple with a guaranteed place in next week's grand final is... Alicia and Matthew!
And I'm saving Matt and Flavia.
The night belongs to Gethin and Camille.
I have to save Matt and Flavia. Okay.
Just watching those two dances, I have to go with Matt and Flavia.
Matthew, Matt and Flavia join us now. And was it a really tense moment when Arlene said she was going to save Gethin and Camilla?
Yeah, I don't know. We've been in two dance-offs and she hasn't sided with us once.
You're joking.
No, last time she took Penny and...
Really?
Yeah.
It's me and her over.
Ah. Well, you just missed her. She was in here about 20 minutes
ago. You'd have a word with her about that.
You've got five dances to get through this weekend and you were saying... You know, you're feeling the pace already. Looking marvellous, but you're feeling a bit tired already.
I feel awful.
Oh. Really?
My body's absolutely exhausted.
And this is just...
bruised.
Look at my bruises.
Is that Matthew?
That's Matthew.
He's
what sort of dances are they?
No, we have two we've done before, and we have a Viennese together. We have to dance on the floor, and then a judge's choice, and then a show dance.
So which dance is the bruise dance?
The lift.
The show dance.
Trying to find a lift we can do well. He's like, okay.
Because I'm really heavy, and he finds it hard to lift me. We tried so many lifts, but they never quite work, do they?
Not really. Drops are good.
Drops.
Yeah. Drops are good. They're quite easy.
You've got to lift first to drop. That's the problem.
Not really.
How are your lifts going?
The lifts is actually the thing I'm liking most about the whole dance.
Yeah, we enjoy the lifts, don't we?
Are you covered in bruises?
We've got some risky ones. Yeah, we are, completely. Yeah, bruises and cuts and all sorts of things.
That's just when I get angry, though. No, but the lifts are the best thing about it, because she's very light and very easy to lift, so I'm quite lucky.
Yes.
Yeah, we've got some risky ones in there, so...
Mm. Risky ones? Death-defying lifts.
That's the that's the show dance. What's the judge's choice? What does that mean?
We like to boogie.
That's the one.
On a Saturday night. It's really cool, actually.
Yes.
They're quick stepping.
We start quick stepping in there.
They take over with a jive.
Jive.
Okay. It'd be good.
Last week was a huge test for you, particularly, Matt, because of what went on the week before.
We won't talk about that.
But then, boy, you really came back. How did you get through that? How is it? Some people would have thought, I can't go back and do that again.
I thought I couldn't. I didn't think I could go back and do it again. But it was kind of, it was a single swim and I just... In a way, I'm glad it happened because it was such an important time, and I realised, you know what?
It couldn't get any worse.
It can't get any worse. If I just go out there and enjoy it, let's see what happens.
And not only did it, it just didn't get worse, it got better and better, and eventually you ended up scoring a perfect score, the only perfect score in the competition for the awards.
We didn't actually realise it was the first one, so we were just a bit kind of standardly happy.
But having said that, in the final, you're against somebody who is technically the best on scores,
definitely.
The best
dancer
ever in the competition. Because you've had more tens than anybody up to this point. You didn't get four tens, but you've had, 40? Is it?
14 tens.
14
I'm keeping count for you.
Thank you. Yes. And you're going to tell me, I didn't notice. And then,
I've still technically got a lot of things to improve on, but we're just really, do you know what? This final is just going to be a celebration of the whole experience.
Yeah,
the whole experience has been amazing and look, can't wait.
Craig says all you've got to get right is your footwork. I think your footwork is perfect.
It's not, it's so not perfect. But I think, you know, Matt's done a wonderful job in the short time that we've had to learn these amazing dances. But to be perfect on your footwork is a lot to ask, you know.
No, there's so much to think about, though.
Yeah, it's so much going on. And when you go out there, you're so nervous and the adrenaline takes over.
But you never look particularly nervous.
Well, I am.
Really, you're hiding
I just hide it in my face, I think, you know.
That's very good. Very good. Flavia, what have you got to look out? What's Matt got to look out for? What are you going to be sort of saying to him at the last?
I think, you know, in the final, I think all I want is to go out there and do what we did last week, just enjoy it as much as possible. It's the last time we're going to get to dance, and you know, it's just got to be a good show. Yeah. So I think as long as we all go out there and, you know, do the best we can, and put on a great show for everybody, and then what happens, happens. You know, we've got so far that I think we just need to try and enjoy it.
And I think the shame for all of us watching, since the last time we get to see you, all of you dance.
Like, I'm more sad about the thought of not dancing with Matt anymore. That's sad.
You can carry on.
Can we carry on? Put him in a cupboard and just get him out every once in a while.
Will you? We're going to have to. Will you carry on dancing together? Is that something that you can? You presumably can try and arrange.
Can we?
Of course we can.
Can I become your partner?
I'm on telly asking. Are you going to carry a dance with
her? Yeah, totally. Yeah, it's going to be great.
Listen, girl, thank you very much for not only for being here today, but for all the entertainment you've given us over the past 3 months. Wishing you all the very best of luck.
Are you missing it?
I hope you enjoy. Am I missing it? No. Because I love watching you guys. That's why.
Cool. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We'll look forward to it tomorrow evening.
Let's go back to some other dancers now. The Natural History Museum in central London. And these guys, honestly, they're just as good as this lot, easily. Wouldn't you say?
Is somebody coming behind
For goodness, I was looking for someone else. Welcome back to Natural History Museum. We've had a great time here with our Christmas special.
It has been brilliant fun. It's getting really busy here. The market traders are setting up now.
It certainly is, but we've got one more special act for you. I would say they're a group of hunks, wouldn't you?
Oh, yes, and I just wish I brought my mistletoe with me today.
They're a group of hunks that got together with Facebook, or through Facebook. They got £1 million recording contract. They then had their debut album go gold. They are, of course, Blake. And here they are singing their version of White Christmas. Take it away, fellas.
May your days be merry and bright. And may all your Christmases
so much for coming. Everyone else that's been on the programme has frozen themselves solid to come in. We've got one question, haven't we, Carol? Is it going to be a white Christmas? Come
on. Let's hope so.
Well, I can answer that, actually. No, it's not.
What's it going to be like today, then, anyway, for everyone driving home?
Today it's going to be cold and grey. We've had some snow grains around this morning, actually, in Somerset. And there is one definite way of having a white Christmas. Christopher Hollins.
That's about it from us. Thank you very much. Have a great Christmas, and we'll see you in the new year. And poor old Bill, he'll be back on Christmas Day. But for all of us here,
Merry
bye-bye,
Christmas.
See you soon. Bye-bye.
And let all your Christmases be white.
You're singing Taxi. Doesn't get any better. Maybe it's cold outside.
Exactly.
Oh, my goodness. Funny girl.